Think of the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, because we grew up with that as kids. You know, Europe and America are getting farther and farther apart. It's being torn apart in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. That's the same tear that's happening here. Australia and Antarctica getting a little bit farther apart. Let me zoom you right in and underwater. So what happens when that happens? Well, you know what? Iceland has volcanoes because of that tear. Well, under the sea here in this part of the world, there are volcanoes here. One right there, a couple more there in the background, but very rugged where that tear is too. So very sharp edges, not deep trenches like the Mariana Trench 7 miles deep, but still up and down and up and down. Not some nice flat landscape that you might hope for here. There's one of the volcanoes we saw, and that's literally right under the search area for today. This literally is one of the most desolate parts away from land as far as you can get, just about. I have to go 900 miles to this French Ocean island here, Port-au-Prince. It's about 50 scientists that live right there. Not an airport at all on this island, but that is the closest island to the search area. Now, we'll talk about the weather for just a second because I want to touch on what's going on. The weather in the search area today is absolutely perfect. But can they get there? There's a lot of weather, Aaron, in between Perth and the search area. And right through here, severe turbulence. There's Perth, search area down here, and icing. So I assume that we're going to get a slowdown or a slight delay tonight for those takeoffs, simply because some planes do better in icing and in turbulence than others. They'll have to wait for that icing to kind of go away. There's still plenty of time. Literally, you know, it's only 7 a.m., so there's plenty of daylight hours. But remember, up here in the northern hemisphere, we are getting more and more daylight as the days go on. Down there, the southern hemisphere gets less and less daylight. The days get shorter and shorter, Aaron.
All right, and Chad, I mean, just a quick follow-up. You know, you talk about that French island. A Foreign Policy magazine had written about that. They said something that the French were going to use it as a penal colony back in the day, but it was so remote and the conditions so horrific that they thought it would be unfair to even jail people there.
You know, it appears to me like a perfect place to visit, but I sure wouldn't want to live here. There's a great little, I bet the fishing here is amazing. The record high in March, one of the hottest parts of the year, is 70. The normal high is 50, surrounded by ocean water, a very desolate place. There are no indigenous people on this island at all, only some French scientists, and they don't live there that long. They go on and off because it is so desolate down here.